In the previous unit, we ran simulation for Cedar Creek. Now let's see the results from that simulation. To look at the results, you can go to the results tab here in the Watershed Explorer, and then you will see the simulations run folder. Go to run 1. That's the name we gave to our simulation. After you expand run 1, you will see all the elements here. So we can first look at the global summary. So global summary will give you all the information that you need to know for each sub-basin in a summary form. So you can see the drainage area associated with all the sub-basins, what the peak discharge is from each sub-basin, and what the time of peak is, and the volume of the total discharge. And after the sub-basins, you will see sink 1. So sink 1 is the name of the outlet that we have. So the area that you see for sink 1 is the total area of Cedar Creek. The peak discharge is the peak of the total discharge at the outlet, and this is the volume of the total discharge at the outlet. So if you want to do the water balance, you can find out how much water came out as discharge at the sink. So it was 1.27, and if we know what the total depth of our rainfall is, we can subtract that from the total discharge volume, and then we will get loss at the outlet. So this is the global summary table. You can also look at what happened individually for each sub-basin. So I'm just going to click on one of the sub-basins. You expand, and then you will see a lot of tables and graphs. So let's look at the graph here, and the graph gives you the rainfall hydrograph for that sub-basin and the discharge output from the sub-basin. And then in the rainfall hydrograph, you will see some of it is red and some of it is in blue. So the red is all the loss and blue is the excess rainfall. And then you see the hydrograph for your sub-basin. We also have summary table for each sub-basin, and that summary table also gives the peak value, but it also gives the sort of water budget or water balance. So we have the precipitation volume, which is 9.46, loss volume and excess volume. Then we also have time series table for sub-basin 6. So the time series table basically gives the rainfall hydrograph and the direct runoff hydrograph at the end. So precipitation will give the rainfall hydrograph, loss, excess rainfall, direct flow. We did not have any base flow, so that's why the base flow column has zero values. And then the total flow gives the hydrograph. So this is what you can see for each sub-basin. So you can then click on all the other graph. Outflow is the hydrograph at the sub-basin outlet. Cumulative outflow is just the accumulation. Precipitation, cumulative precipitation, soil infiltration. So in this case, all the loss that we had was soil infiltration. So this is the excess rainfall and precipitation loss and so on. We can also look at the sink 1 graph. So sink 1 graph will give you the total hydrograph at the outlet. So we have two types of lines here. One is this dashed line, the other one is solid blue line. So the dashed line is the inflow data from the sub-basin immediately upstream of the outlet, and then that dashed line is added to the total hydrograph coming from all the other outlets, and then we will get the solid blue line. So the solid blue line is the hydrograph at the watershed outlet. We can also look at the summary table at the sink, and again we will see the peak discharge and volume. We have the time series table. So if we were to plot information at the watershed outlet, we will use the sink 1 information. So similarly, again, we have outflow, cumulative outflow, and combined inflow, and so on. So this is how you can look at the results for sub-basins. We can also look at the reach. what each reach will do is it will take the input from the upstream sub-basin, route it and give it as input to the downstream sub-basin or reach. So for each reach, you will see two types of plot in the graph. One is the dashed line and the other one is the solid line. So dashed line is the input to the reach. It is then routed to get the solid line, which is the output from the reach. And then again, we have the summary table, time series table. So inflow is the input and outflow is the routed flow. And again, you will see the plot for all of those. And this is how you look at the results. Now, what we have here at the sink one is what the model produced. So what we are interested in looking at is how good the model output is compared to what was observed. So in order to do that comparison, we need to bring in the observed data from the Excel file into HEC-HMS. So to do that, we will go to components. So similar to creating a precipitation gauge, now we will create a discharge gauge. So we will go to components, time series data manager, and instead of precipitation gauge here for data type, we will pick discharge gauges and say new. And gauge one is fine. So for description, we will say observed discharge at Cedar Creek outlet, create. And then in the Watershed Explorer, you will see a discharge gauge added under the time series data. So gauge one. So cubic meters per second, that's the entry we have. The time interval that we have is 1 hour. And then after we input that, we will click on the plus sign next to gauge one for discharge gauge, and we'll provide the start date and time and end date and time. So our start date was 21st February 2005. So the start time is 0100, end time is 25th of February 2005, and we know the data ended at 6 a.m. And once we provide this input, it will create the table similar to what we saw before for precipitation. So to get all the numbers, we'll go to Excel and copy our discharge column or flow column, Control C, and then come back, right click and paste, and we have all our discharge values, and save. Now, right now we have this discharge gauge. What we are going to do is we are going to link that to sink one. So to link the discharge gauge to sink one, click on sink one in Watershed Explorer, go to options, and then observed flow. Right now it is none, and we'll change that to gauge one. So let's save our project and let's run our simulation one more time. After we run our simulation, the model output is the blue hydrograph. The observed data is the black hydrograph. So you can see that our model is overestimating significantly. And now our goal is to calibrate our model to match the simulated hydrograph with the observed hydrograph, which we will learn in the next module. So this is the end of this unit and this module. Save your project, and this finishes our module for creating HEC-HMS model for Cedar Creek.